Today I'm experimenting with different types of jewel thieves and coils and whatever, and one problem I've got is that all of my LEDs that are low voltage have these short little leads on them, like that. So what I've got to do is I've got to solder a new lead on here to make it longer so it'll do what I want it to do. And the issue there is that when you solder here, yeah, it'll stay there. You got to clamp it on. It's kind of inconvenient. You clamp it on. But as soon as you solder the other end down here, this end pops off. So how do you do that without having a bunch of clamps or five hands or whatever? So let me show you a trick or two on how to do that and save yourself some aggravation. The first step is to find yourself some wire. I really like this stuff. This is wire wrap wire, and they don't use it much anymore. It's plated wire, it solders very nicely, and I think you can probably pick it up pretty cheaply since it's not very popular anymore. So you get yourself some thin wire like this. You can also get it from things like, here's an old communication cable, and it's got like a million leads on it. And it's got some very fine wire in there, so you can strip out one of these and take out one of these wires. This stuff also works well because it's plated. And another place you can get it, although it's a little bit thicker, is from just some zip cord, some lamp cord, whatever. Get the skinniest stuff you can and pluck out one of these leads. Get it there in focus for you. And as you can see, it's not very thick stuff, but it's nice and shiny copper and it will also work. So okay, first step, get yourself some very fine thin wire. What I'm going to do is just simply wrap those two things together and form a nice mechanical connection that I can solder. And once I do that, then when I'm soldering the other end, even if this end melts, it's going to stay there. I'm not going to try to show you this process live on camera because it's, I'll just keep bumping the camera. I'm so close to the lens right now. And it'll keep going out of focus. But the first step is to just put it on there, and you can see I've just got one wrap around there like this. And kind of get in the middle and then start one leg going towards the LED and the other leg start wrapping it away from the LED like that. And use tweezers if you have to. I've got some ordinary ladies tweezers, whatever I bought from the pharmacy, and whatever it takes to get it on there. Get it on there as tightly as you can. As you can see, I've just got it wrapped around there. It's not, there's no magic to it. Just wrap it around there so it's somewhat tight. The legs on there are somewhat tight. You can see I can move it like this and it won't come loose. So then the next step is to go solder that. I will do that. Be right back. So there's the first one all soldered up. As you can see, it's not too bad. It forms a nice leg. When you're doing this, you may want to consider which side of the pin you solder them on. Do you want to solder both on the same sides, opposite sides, on the side over here, on the outside, the inside, whatever, for your spacing. But that's pretty tough. Also, while you're wrapping it to help tighten it, you can literally put your tweezers in there and twist them around like this if you're careful not to move your leg around. And that's it. Well, let me do the other one. And this is it using the piece from the zip cord, the lamp cord you saw earlier. Call it an inch and a half, 3-point-some centimeters, like that, of wire. And you can wrap it around by grabbing it and twisting it this way. And sometimes I just tuck the wire in like this, pull it out from the other side, kind of like sewing. Stuff it back in this side, pull it tight, keep going around in a circle. Just like your stitching, requires a little bit of patience, but that's it. Go solder this and then I'll be done. And here we are, all done. I'm not sure you can tell which is which anymore, but yeah, so now I have my extended leads and I can go back to making my next jewel thief. Well, hope you found it useful.